Hello students, welcome for the question answers of the chapter 4 history. So we have already covered the chapter explanation, so let's start with the question answers today. The chapter name is the Central Islamic Lands. Question 1, what were the features of the lives of the Bedouins in the early 17th century? The Bedouins were Arab tribes. The main features of their lives are as follows. They led a nomadic life. They were indulged in looting, plundering, and internal quarrels. They were camel pastoralists and moved with their animals from oasis to oasis. Date palm and camel milk were their main diet. Their social organization was based on independent tribes. Question 2. What is meant by the term Abbasid Revolution? The term Abbasid Revolution refers to the Dawa movement initiated by Abu Muslim from Khusran against the Umayyad dynasty. This revolution put an end to the Umayyad dynasty, which ruled from 661 to 750 CE. This was the fall of Umayyad dynasty in 750. The Abbasids came to power and ruled till 1258. Question 3. Give examples of the cosmopolitan characters of the state set up by Arabs, Iranians, and Turks. The examples of the cosmopolitan characters of the state set up by Arabs, Iranians, and Turks. The vast Arab Empire was inhabited by the people of multicultural identities, that is Muslims, the Christians, and the Jews. The Iranian Empire witnessed for the development of Muslims and Asian cultures. And Turkish Empire, the Egyptian, Iranian, Syrians, and Sudanese culture developed simultaneously. Question 4. What were the effects of the Crusades in Europe and Asia? The effect of the Crusades on Europe and Asia. The Crusade resulted in the fall of the authority of feudal lords in Europe and an increased power of the monarch. These Crusades also resulted into increase in the knowledge of the Europeans. They were surprised to see the progress made by the Muslims in the field of art, science, and literature. There were great influence of the Italian mercantile communities in trade between the East and the West. These were led to change in the method of warfare. For defense purpose, new forts were constructed. Question 5. How were Islamic architecture forms different from those of Roman Empire? Roman architecture. The Roman architectural forms or buildings were solid and magnificent. These features were the key features of the Roman architecture form introduced to architecture features, the arc and cupolas or domes. There were multi-storied buildings with one row arches standing over the another. Round arches were used in city gates, bridges, buildings, and monuments of victory. The spread of Christianity gave a new impetus to the building of the Roman Empire. Saint Sophia in Constantinople and buildings in Jerusalem stand witness to the Roman architectural skill. Islamic architecture. Islamic architecture form represent the greatest architectural symbol of Islamic world. The Islamic art right from Spain to Central Asia represents some basic architectural features such as horse show arches, gubbas, domes, minarets, columns, and open courtyard. The Islamic architecture pattern of building built around the central courtyard was not only the key features of the mosque but also of sarai and palaces. Calligraph and geometrical designs were also used to decorate architecture and manuscript. Describe a journey from Samarkand to Damascus referring to the cities on the route. Answer. Let's start the short question answers that you can do by yourself that question. What are the five pillars of Islam? Five pillars of Islam are: there is only one God, that is Allah. Namaz should be offered five times in a day. Zakat should be given to the needy. Fasting should be kept in the month of Ramzan. All Muslims should take the pilgrimage to Mecca at least once in their lives. Second question, the main teachings of Islam. Explain. The main teachings of Islam are as given. Allah should be worshipped. No Muslim should practice idol worship. It is a sin. Muslims should believe that all Muslims are equal. They should regard themselves as brothers. All Muslims should follow the same rules regarding marriage and divorce. All Muslims should lead a simple life. Question 3. Describe in brief how Prophet Muhammad's religion was a factor in the growth of Arab unity. Prophet Muhammad's religion was a responsible factor in the growth of Arab unity, as the religion started by him was denoted by a term Islam, implied a complete submission. He told that there is one God, Allah. He emphasized on the principles of equality and unity for those who accepted Allah and Prophet. What do you know about the Arab tribe? The entire Arab society was divided into tribes known as Kabila, headed by the chief. The chief of Kabila was elected on the basis of his family, wisdom, and courage. Besides these, his personality also played a crucial role. Each tribe had its own religious beliefs. They worshipped their own gods and goddesses in mosques. These tribes were nomadic and kept on moving from one region to another in search of food and fodder for their camels. Some of them settled and practiced trade on agriculture. Muhammad's own tribe was Quraysh, who had resumed its supremacy in Mecca. It established its control over Kaaba, a cubic-like structure in which idols were placed. Even the tribe outside Mecca considered the Kaaba, installed their own idols at this shrine, making annual pilgrimage to the Hajj. What were Crusades? Describe its two impacts on the Christian-Muslims relation. Crusades meant the military expansion. It was organized in the Western Christendom to recover the holy place of Palestine from the Muslim occupation. The four Crusades were as follows. The first Crusade was 1095 to 1099, second 1147 to 1148, third 1189 to 1192, and the fourth was 1202 to 1204 CE. The fourth we have not read in the chapter. The impact of Christian-Muslims relations. Even since the Crusade, people of Western Christendom developed a stereotypic and destroyed Islamic image. These wars resulted in harsher attitude of Muslim states towards its Christian subjects. Write any four factors responsible for the rise of Arab Empire. The following factors are responsible for the rise of the Arab Empire. Arabs were skilled warriors. The Arabs were successful merchants who maintained their trade relations with the far-off countries. The spread of Islam in different countries also helped them in consolidating their empire. They collected information from the valuable sources and developed it still further. Question 7. Why did the early caliphate follow an expansionist policy? Which factor contributed to their success? The early caliphate followed an expansionist policy because they were well aware about the fact that Ummah could not be maintained, but the modest income had to taken through trade and taxes. They realized that a rich booty could be obtained by expanding raids. The Byzantine and Sasanian empires patronized Christianity and Jordanism respectively. On the eve of Arabs' invasions, both these empires began to decline. This provided an opportunity to the Arabs to expand their empire. The following factors contributed to their success. Arabs used camels, which could work easily in desert regions. Both Byzantine and Sasanian empires were not in a position to face the determined challenges of Arab because they were on the way of their decline. Question 8. Describe some features of administrative structures of Arabs under the early Khalifa. Answer: features of administrative structures. Arab states were headed by governors called Amirs and the tribal chieftains called Ashraf. Tax paid by the Muslims and the shares obtained from the booty were the main source of income for the central authority. The ruling class and the soldiers received their share in the booty and monthly payment. The non-Muslim resident in the Arab administration had to pay taxes. These taxes were jizya and kharaj. Christians and Jews were declared as protected citizens. Both were given autonomy in conducting communal affairs. Write in brief about the contributions of Arab civilization to the world in the field of science. The Arab astronomers proved that Earth is round and it revolves around the sun. They discovered compounds like sodium carbonate, silver nitrates, nitrates, and sulfuric acids. In the field of mathematics, they excluded a numbers and trigonometry. They spread this knowledge to the other parts of the world. Two great Arab physicians, Al-Razi and Ibn Sina, told about the smallpox and the tuberculosis. List the responsible factors that enabled the Umayyad to come to power. The Umayyad dynasty was founded by Muawiyah in 661 CE. Between the year 661 to 750, all caliphs were from Umayyad's dynasty. Following factors enable Umayyads to coming into the power. With the territorial expansion, the Umayyad unity was broken up. Conflicts over the distribution of resources begin to increase among the Ummah. The Makkah characters of the early Islamic states of by Umayyad, who packed this administration with his own men, to his exclusion of other tribesmen to secure greater central. Opposition of Tuber men in Iraq and Egypt combined the opposition of Medina led to assassination of Umayyad. After his assassination, Ali became the fourth caliphate. The rifts deepened, and after his assassination, Muawiyah successfully made him the next caliph. To exclusion of Ali's own Hussein, Ali's son Hussein, founding Umayyad's dynasty. Write a revolutionary note on the regime of the fourth caliphate Ali. Ali was the fourth caliphate. He found two wars against those who were representing the astro Prophecy of Makkah. As a result of these wars, the rifts among the Muslims depends. Later on, his supporters and enemies got divided into two sects. These two sects were Saha and Sunnis. Ali established himself as Kufar and defeated Aisha's, that was a Muhammad's wife, army in the Battle of Camel in 657. Although Ali won this war, but he was unable to suppress the group led by Muawiyah, a kinsman of Uthman and governor of Syria. He then fought another war with him at Siffin, which enabled inner twins. After the war of Siffin, Ali's followers got divided into two groups. Some remained loyal to them, while others who left them came to be known as Kharij. Question 12. During Abbasids, Arab influence began to decline. Why? During Abbasid, the Arab influence began to decline on account of the following reasons. The Abbasids established their capital at Baghdad, near the ruins of ancient Iranian metropoles. Christianion. As a result of this, the Iranian influence of culture began to increase under Abbasid. The Abbasid rule strengthened the religious status and functions of the caliphates and patronized Islamic institutions and scholars. The army and bureaucrats were recognized on a non-tribal basis to ensure greater participation of Iraqis and Khurasani. The Abbasid maintained the magnificent imperial architectures of Umayyads. They also elaborated court ceremonies of Umayyads. The Umayyads sought to legitimate their rule, explained by giving example. The Umayyads sought to legitimize their rule by protecting themselves as religious leaders and always appealed for unity and suppressed their rebels on the name of the Islam. They too wanted to retain their social identity. The Umayyad Sultan Abd al-Malik replaced Greek and Pahlavi with Arabic as a language of administration. Now the use of Arabic became compulsory for administrative purpose. He also replaced gold dinar and silver dirham circulation. Hadith building activities were undertaken that were related to the mosques and palaces. Were the Abbasids ruler able to abolish monarch? Abbasids rulers were unable to abolish monarch because the needs of the government and the empire forced them to retain centralized army. The Abbasids, who claimed to bring downfall of monarchy, established monarchy again by maintaining magnificent imperial architecture and court ceremonies initiated by the Umayyads. Which factors were responsible for contributing unity among Islamic society between 950 to 1200 CE? The following factors contributed to the unity of Islamic society between 950 to 1200 CE. First, these societies were brought together by common culture and economic patterns. The state was separated from the society. The Persian developed a common language which brought the people together. Merchants, artists, scholars all moved freely within the central Islamic land, which led to the circulation of new ideas and thoughts. The population of Muslims began to increase enormously. It was earlier less than 10% under the Umayyads and early Abbasid people. Question 16. Which factors contributed to the commercial prosperity of the central Islamic lands? The following factors contributed to the commercial prosperity of the Islamic lands. The Islamic land was politically unified as a result of increasing urbanization. This land was spread between the trading zones of the Indian Ocean and Meridian. increasing flow of pilgrims to Mecca was also considered as an important factor. Towns such as Baghdad and Damascus developed a warehouse centers for local consumption and onward transmissions of high-value goods such as textile, gunpowder, spices, propane shipped from India to China to Bed Sea and Gulf parts of this Saraf and Basra. Question 17. What is the right importance about the Shahnameh? Shahnameh is a great historical political work of Firdowsi. It is an epic of 50,000 culprits and also a masterpiece of Islamic literature. It took nearly 30 years to complete. Ghazni became the important center of Persian literary life. The rulers of Ghazni also patronized art and learning for enhancing their prestige. Shahnameh is a collection of tradition and legends which depicts Iran from creation up until the Arab conquest. According to the Ghaznavi's traditions, Persian later became the language of the administration and culture in India. How do caliphates break up in Arab empire? Explain. From 9th century, Abbasid state became weaker due to decline of Baghdad's control over distant provinces and continuous struggle between pro-Arab and pro-Iranian groups in the army and bureaucracy. In 810, a civil war broke out between the supporters of two sons, Amin and Muawim, of the caliphate Harun al-Razid. This war created a new power blocks of Turkish slave officer. From the orthodox to of poverty, the Shah started competing with Sunni. As a result of this, many new dynasties like Tahrir, Samirin, and Tulumins came into being. As a result of this, the Abbasid power got limited to the areas of the central Iraq and western Iran. The Buyids captured Baghdad in 945 CE, which entered Abbasid supremacy. Question number 19. Describe the distribution of agricultural land in the conquest territories of Arabs from the aspects of ownership. The Arabs mainly practiced agriculture in the territories conquered by them. The Islamic State did not make any changes in it. Both small as well as the large land owners were the owners of the land. In some cases, the land was also owned by the state. In Iraq, the land was divided into very large units cultivated by peasants. The state's owners were given the responsibility of land revenue collections on behalf of the state. During the Caesarian and the Islamic period, land was a common property. In villages, people practiced both nomadic and settled agriculture. After Islamic conquest, some changes began to take place. Big estates acquired by the state began to abandon by their landowners. Now they were handed over to the Muslim elites, especially to those who were the number of the caliphate's family. Question 20. What was the center of Abbasid uprising? Why did it take place? Give reasons. The Umayyad's dynasty was brought down by a well-organized movement called Dawa. It was then replaced by Abbasid in 750. The main center of their uprising was the distant region of Khorasan. The main reason for this is mobilization of the mixed Iranian population for various reasons. The Umayyads projected themselves rested on force and royalty of Syrian troops, which resented the Arab soldiers. The Arab civilians disliked the Umayyads' regions for failure to fulfill their promises. Umayyad's regime was portrayed as an evil by the Abbasids. What were the reasons for the breakup of the caliphates and the rise of the concept of sultans? The downfall of the Abbasid dynasty paved the way to the rise of the concept of sultanates. The causes mainly responsible were the successor of Amun were very weak and incapable. They paid no heed towards the administrative affairs. Under such circumstances, the downfall of the caliphates was sure. The caliphate paid no attention towards their army. They were leading a life full of luxury and paid no attention towards the problems of common people. Now, let's move to the long question answers. Describe the major beliefs and practices that characterize Sufism. The Sufi were a group of religious-minded people turned to asceticism and mysticism. Sorry. Their major beliefs and practices were given below. The Sufis laid emphasis on seeking of salvation through devotion of God. They laid emphasis on celibacy and ignored the rituals and observed extreme forms of asceticism. They considered everyone equal in the eye of God. God is one and almighty. Everyone in the universe is his creation. They interpreted the Quran on the basis of their own experience. They maintain a distance from the worldly power. They used to go for ziyarat. They remembered God by reciting the divine names of evoking his presence through Sama. They regarded Prophet Muhammad as a perfect man, human being, and preached to follow his teachings. Sufis were in favor of Sama, singing and dancing. What do you know about the main teachings of Islam? Main teachings are as follows. Idol worship is a curse according to Islam. God, that is Allah, is Almighty. He is all wise and merciful. Islam believes in life after death, in hell or heaven. The sinner will go to the hell and face many hardships. The religious and honest people will go to the heaven. They will be served by beautiful damsels. The Quran is the divine book of Islam. The saying of the Prophet Muhammad are regarded as God. All are equal. No one is superior or inferior. Islam preached the principle of equality and brotherhood. There is no restriction on keeping slaves in Islam, but Muhammad asked his followers to treat them kindly. Questions 3. Write your argument to justify the following statement. Prophet Muhammad laid down the foundation of a new political structure. Answer. Prophet Muhammad laid down the foundation of a new political structure. He replaced the tribal organization with a state. The state was encompassed with a number of tribes. Umar constituted the armed forces. He was a religious leader as well as a lawgiver. His followers, that is Umar, were converted into a wide community to include polytheists and Jews of Medina. The conquest of Makkah established him both as a religious as well as political leader. He maintained the independence of the state by fixing the booty to 1/15, which directly went to him. Tax like zakat was imposed on tribes who had accepted Muhammad's leadership. All Muslim tribes had to pay it. With his efforts and influence, he was able to convert many Bedouins into Islam. In a short span of time, he was able to unite a large part of peninsula. Question 4. Throughout the history of human being, their interest in religion often went hand in hand. Justify the statement by giving example. from the very beginning, evidence has been traced out that Indian traders traveled to the different countries of the Southeast Asia for trade in gold, tin, spices, etc. While traveling and trading to these nations, they also took with them the idea and practices of the religion. The ideologies of Buddhism and Hinduism became the part and parcel of their structure. These two religions were adopted by the people of Java, Cambodia, Sri Lanka, etc. The Arab traders in the medieval period established their trade relations with India and many other countries of Europe and Asia. They carried with them the ideas of newly founded religion, that is Islam. Due to its simplicity in principles, Islam was adopted by many Indians, and in the same way it is spread into Spain, Syria, Iran and Iraq. The traders of the Western countries, that is traders of England, Holland, France, etc., spread their trading relations to in many countries. They brought with them the ideas of Christianity. While trading, they also spread Christianity into different countries. Today, this region is adopted by the people of different countries of Asia and Africa. Keeping the above examples in mind, we can conclude that throughout the history, human beings' interest in religion went hand in hand. Question 5. Discuss the main source of income of the state in detail. Agriculture was the main occupation of the settled population since long. It also remained a major occupation in newly acquired territories. The bulk of income of the state was derived from the agricultural land. Land was owned by a small and big farmers, and in some cases by the state. After Islamic conquest, big estates were abandoned and acquired by the state. Later on, these estates were handled over by the Muslim elites. The chiefs among them were the members of the caliphs, that is caliphate's army. The land acquired by the Arabs, which remain in the hand of the owners of the subjected to a tax called kharaj, varied from 1/12 to 1/5 of the produce, while the land cultivated by the Muslims were levied 1/10 of tax, known as urs, as a land revenue. When non-Muslims started converting to Islam, their land revenue income fell dramatically. To meet the shortfall, the caliphs decided to discourage the conversion and later adopted a uniform land revenue policy. After 10th century, the state authorized its officials to claim salaries from the agricultural territories called ektas. Agricultural prosperities and political stability went hand in hand. To ensure agricultural prosperity, it took several measures such as canals were constructed, dams were built, the digging of wells, etc. were done. Tax concessions were granted to those people who brought land under cultivation. By the initiatives of the peasants and state support, the agriculture began to increase. Many new crops such as cotton, oranges, bananas, watermelon, Spanish, brinjal began to grow and even exported to Europe. So let's start some passage based questions. So we have these passages from the book itself. The first one is the Islamic calendar, which is very important. On the basis of this, you can see questions and their answers. We have a second paragraph, that is the ideal student. It is also from the book. Here we have the questions from this passage. I And the last one is the map. This you have to locate on the Islamic lands, that is the Arabic Peninsula. Map is also here, you can check it. Okay, I hope now you can do the notebook work easily. So all the question answers should be done in your notebook. So now thank you and have a nice day.